The Emperor Jones is a play written by Eugene O'Neill, and there are 8 scenes in total. Now we can see scene by scene summary of this play. Scene 1, you can see that it's a late afternoon and the audience chamber in the palace of Emperor is shown. Main characters in scene 1 is a native Negro woman, Smithers and Jones. As the curtain raises, we can see that the Negro woman is trying to sneak out of the palace cautiously. She is a very old woman, and when she tries to escape, Smithers appears with a riding whip and he catches her, and then he threatens her. And when he is threatening her, she kneels down on the ground and pleads him not to tell this to Jones. Smithers is the only white man in this play, tall, round-shouldered, about 40. Then follows the conversation between the woman and Smithers, where she reveals him about the plan of all the Negroes. Except the woman, all other servants have left to the hills because the woman is too old. That's the only reason why she is left behind, and she is telling him that she too will go. Smithers then awakes Emperor Jones by whistling, and Emperor Jones wakes up so angrily and asks him who dared to wake him up. So Smithers tells the newts that all the servants have escaped, and then follows the conversation between Smithers and Jones. From their conversation we can understand 3 important things, and that is, firstly, Jones have escaped from the jail and reached this place, and second, how Jones became the emperor. That is, Jones became the emperor by fooling the Negroes. When one of the Negroes tried to kill him, the bullet went into some other direction, not killing Jones. So Jones made up a story that lead bullet can't kill him and only silver bullet can kill him. And he became the emperor because Negroes were poor and couldn't get a silver bullet. Third one is, Jones have 6 bullets, out of which 5 are lead and 1 is a silver bullet. Jones said the Negroes that he saved the silver bullet to kill himself when it is time. Towards the end of this scene, Jones leaves the palace bidding goodbye to Smithers to the forest. Scene 2. Nightfall at the end of a plain where the great forest begins. So by scene 2 we can see it's dawn, and John enters from the left rapidly looking for some familiar landmarks and stops at the edge of a forest and lays on the ground extremely tired. And there was no horses for him, so he came by walking. In scene 1 it is mentioned, so we can see that he is alone and talking to himself. There was no moonlight and it was to get darker as Smithers told him. Here there is no other characters other than Jones. So Jones was talking to himself and it was too dark, and he starts to feel uneasy with the growing noise of a beating of tom-tom. Then he starts to console himself by saying that Negroes are miles away from him and that he needed not to worry. And he says to himself that all the uneasiness is because his stomach is empty and he is hungry. And he looked for the food. He hid under the white stones covered with an oilcloth, but it was not found. And suddenly a little formless creature creeping through the deep blackness of the forest. They are black, shapeless, and only their glittering eyes can be seen. And when Jones looked back to the forest, wondering if he had lost his way, he saw the little formless creatures laughing low mockingly like a rustling of leaves. Jones fires the little creatures and they vanished. And he thought they are little wild pigs and that they would have ate his food. At the end of this scene, Jones enters the forest boldly. In scene 3, it is 9 o'clock in the forest. As scene 3 opens, the tom-tom noise is heard louder than before, and the Negro, Jeff, is seen sitting on the ground playing the dice. So Jeff, the Emperor Jones have killed Jeff earlier, but here in this scene 3, Jones is seeing Jeff again. So Jones has lost his hat and his face is scratched and his clothes are torn here and there. So the moon has risen, giving clear view of the path for Jones. And As he walks forward, he hears the noise of dice and moves to that direction and finds Jeff. He gets frightened and keeps questioning Jeff that he have killed him and how he have reached here and such questions. And he also asks him if he is a ghost. Jeff didn't reply anything. Jeff just sat there playing the dice. So John's fired at Jeff and Jeff disappeared from there. So this is the second time Emperor John's is firing and he have lost two bullets by scene 3. Towards the end of this scene, John's walks into the underbrush in the rear and disappears into the dark. Scene 4, 11 o'clock in the forest. Jones is extremely tired and his clothes are torn and he looks at the road with surprise and falls down heavily and rests. So he sees a road and towards his left and which he have never seen before, and he's surprised by seeing the road and he looks at it. Then Jones keep talking to himself about how tired he is and how exhausted he feels with the cot and removes it. And he looks at the road and shakes his head fearfully, saying the forest is full of curious things at night. So he's scared by seeing all the roads and all these things which he have never seen before. And he is also scared that he have lost his way. So then he prays to God to not see these ghosts again. While after praying, he says to himself that there is no such thing as ghost and only fools believe such things. He says himself to not talk and take rest. While he rests, a group of Negroes enter carrying pickaxes and shovels. White men who seem to dress like prison guards follow the Negroes and they stop near John's. When John sees them, he gets frightened and tries to walk away, but he couldn't move and he again prays to God. The prisoners start digging like those of machines, like so slowly, rigid and in such a way, like a machines, and then John's joined them. John's gets beaten by the white man and he cries loudly. Then John's raises his hand as if he had the shovel in his hand to kill the white man. Then he realizes that his hand is empty and he shouts for a shovel to the prisoners who are digging there. Then towards the end of the scene, John's fires at the white man on the road and everyone disappears and the walls of the forest closes from both sides. Scene 5, 1 o'clock in the forest. John's start praying regretfully, listing down every sin he did, like killing Jeff and fooling Negroes and everything. He lists down every sin he did and then he asks forgiveness and to have mercy upon him. Then he says to God that he is not afraid of real men, but the ghostly figures terrify him, so please take away these ghostly figures and all those things. Then he looks at his feet and removes his shoes, saying it's of no use and his foot were hurt badly. So he throws his shoes away. Then a crowd of figures suddenly enter from all the sides, who were middle-aged men and seemed to be well-to-do planters. And there was one particular individual who seemed to be an auctioneer. It was a slave market and there were so many people who came to enjoy seeing this slave market. And the auctioneer touches John's. They have so many people there, a woman carrying a baby and so many people who were slaves, and they were selling them. And at last, the auctioneer touches John's authoritatively and orders him to stand on the auction block. Firstly, John's tries to escape, but he fails. Then the auctioneer starts his speech, listing the qualities of John's, how John's is a happy man and all those things. And at last, John's bursts out with anger and questions them if they are trying to sell him and that he is the emperor and all those things. Then towards the end of this scene, Jones fires the auctioneer and the planters simultaneously. So and the wall of the forest closes, only blankness and the beating of the tom-tom remained. So in scene 5 he has lost 2 bullets and only blankness and the beating of Tom Tom remained. Scene 6, 3 o'clock at night, in the midnight, a clear space in the forest can be seen, and there is a noise of someone approaching from the left, and John's voice is heard between his moan. He prays to God. He is afraid because all his bullets are gone and now only the silver bullet is left. He is saying to God that he must save the silver bullet, otherwise he would be dead. Then he rests at the clear space, saying that he don't care if the Negroes catch him, but he must rest. And then 2 rows of Negroes wearing loin cloth is seen behind Jones, who were at first silent but slowly started murmuring some prayers or something in a way. Jones look at them terrified and again throws himself down. Then he rises and sits similar to their positions and wails with them. His voice reaches highest pitch of sorrow and misery. And then the other voices ceases and only darkness is left. Towards the end, he gets up and runs further away to the forest. Scene 7, 5 o'clock, the foot of a gigantic tree by the edge of a great river. John's voice can be heard and he wails like a slave and walks like a sleepwalker or in trance. The expression of his face is fixed. He looks at the tree, the moonlit river and the rough stone altar. Then he kneels down the altar and prays as if in obedience of some hidden impulse. Suddenly he gets up realizing what he is doing. He crawls away from the altar and the figure of the Congo witch doctor disappears from behind the tree trunk. John starts dancing as if in response to the tom-tom. The doctor, the witch doctor sways and his voice rises and falls in a ghostly monotonous croon. His croon is a mantra to soften the anchor of some deity. Johns keep dancing and swaying his waist. At last the dancing comes to an end. The witch doctor points the magic rod at Johns. So first he points the rod to the tree, then towards the altar, and then to the river, and then at last to Johns. And then Johns understood the meaning that he has to offer himself for the sacrifice. Then the witch doctor calls out some gods, and the head of a crocodile comes from the river. The glittering green eyes of the crocodile is fixed upon Johns, and the witch doctor points Johns to move towards the monster crocodile. So Johns keep praying to Lord to help him, to save him, and he creeps towards the crocodile. Suddenly, as if in response to his prayer, he remembers the bullet left with him, and he fires at the green eyes in front of him. That was the silver bullet he fired. The witch doctor and the crocodile disappears, and Johns lies with his face on the ground. Scene 8, dawn, same as scene 2, the dividing line of forest and plain can be seen. The tom-tom voice heard louder here. So, Lem, the African wearing loin cloth and a revolver cartridge belt are seen on his waist, and his soldiers carrying rifles enters with smithers. One of the soldiers looks keenly at the place where Johns entered to the forest and points there. And Lem and Smithers goes to that place. Then follows the conversation between Smithers and Lem. Smithers says it's of no use to sit there and wait, that Johns would have gone miles away. But Lem keeps saying with patience that they will catch him for sure. Then, while Smithers was telling all this is nonsense, a voice is heard from the forest and the soldiers stood up with their rifles ready. And when Lem motioned them to move, they moved to the forest noiselessly and each to a different spot. Then again, Smithers starts telling it's nonsense and all these are foolish things to keep waiting here, and that that won't be Johns and it would be someone else. Then Lem tells him to be silent, and then the sound of the rifles is heard from the forest, followed by shouts of joy. Lem tells to Smithers that John is dead. And Lem gave his soldiers money to get silver bullets to kill Jones, because he believed lead bullet could not kill Jones. So this was the response by Lem when Smithers told him about the silver bullet. So Smithers laughs by this response and says that they are not bringing Jones and it is going to be someone else. And the soldiers enters with the body of Jones, and there was a hole under his left wrist. Lem examines his body with satisfaction and confirms that he is dead. Towards the end, Smithers mocks Jones by saying that he died in the height of Styles. And the play ends here by the death of Emperor Jones.